Welcome to the Chattanooga Area Model Railroad Club's Chattanooga Southern, the world's largest HO gauge model railroad located at the Chattanooga Choo Choo. 174 feet long and 33 feet wide at its widest point, the project consists of almost 3,000 feet of track. There are over 150 switches, 800 freight cars, 80 passenger cars, 120 locomotives of all types, 3 major yards, 2 small yards, 2 passenger stations, a replica of Union Station, which for many years housed the famous Civil War locomotive, the General, star of the great locomotive chase, stands arched in memorial and its namesake. This station was raised several years ago. The terminal station was built in 1908 and is now an exciting Chattanooga Choo Choo complex and a National Historic Site. Here you see the trolley car running right in front of the Chattanooga Choo Choo complex, then the Chattanooga Terminal. This trolley car makes a loop under the Lookout Mountain Tunnel, which is in the background. This trolley car runs 12 hours a day, 7 days a week. In the foreground, you see the circus train, which runs also 12 hours a day, 7 days a week, and has been running for the last 3 years. Ah, but this is true. Caution, model railroad is at play. If you watch, we might even catch one now and then. This is a replica of the Citico Yards, which were renovated in 1953 to become the now DeButt Yard. We're closing in on the Missionary Ridge Tunnel, which now belongs to the Tennessee Valley Railroad Museum, which runs a 6-mile line for tourists. This is the town of East Chattanooga, as it stood in about the 1950s. Chattanooga Southern, this is one of the Chattanooga Southern's diesels, which consists of the complete steam and diesel locomotives. As I said, we will catch now and then a few model railroaders at play. In the top left-hand corner, you do see the model of the Lookout Mountain, which is consists of about 200 pounds of plaster. This project was started in 1973. Was completed in 1974 for operation, but will never be completely finished. Now, some people never learn not to hang on the ladders. This section of the layout covers East Tennessee and the mountainous areas. Found another model railroader at work. At any one time on the layout, there are 7 trains running, 1 trolley car. Our newest line completed was the Mountain Line, which covers about 40 to 50 feet of track. In 1 8-foot section, the track rises 1 foot 6 inches. This is the summit of the Mountain Line, which is about 8 feet above the floor. It is the highest point on the layout. You see some of the rugged mountain equipment in the yard at the top. And we have a chassis system locomotive. And a Chattanooga Southern, which pass on the big loop and the short loop. That train is passing the coal yard. And we have a boater in the Wasackee River. We're a long ways down. We're flying in a plane up above the Wasackee River, looking over what things look like. This is typical of logging territory. It's a locomotive crane on a short section of track used to pick up logs and set them on the flat cars to be transported to the mill. Have some avid watchers of the model railroad as it is busy at work. Well, now we have somebody operating controls in the control tower. This is a look from this is as it looks in the CT tower, as it does in many railroads around the country. Okay, next we have the engineer's view. This is what it would look like, an engineer looking out of the locomotive down the track, see what's ahead of him. Actually, it's from the tower. Towers view. I will state to mention that the tower operator did happen to be myself. This small sign here tells about another small logging operation here on the side of the southern main line. This is a very detailed piece of work done by one of the club members here. This tells of a very interesting display on the railroad. It tells about one of our characters in our Mount Rushmore, Miss Polly Darton. And just hope we can all sit down. Of course, some people call it Dolly Parton, but we call her Polly Darton. It's not the name confused. This is the station at Wave Rag Junction in the northern part of the layout. This is the town of Wave Rag Junction at the Railroad Hotel, where you can find most bums and drunks every day of the week and on the weekend. Very long man hours went into putting all this together. The detail is very great in this part of the layout. Here we have a haven for the knights of the road, the hobos that so many times are seen looking out of the door of the boxcar. Who knows, you might know one of them. Have a dance every Saturday night. People kick their heels up here at this little barn dance. Have a good old time the old-fashioned way. They are dancing on stage. Oh, and here we have a wedding.
Anything goes.
Who the lucky girl is. Or the lucky man, whichever way you look at it.
The best way it can be said.
Look in the bushes and see if you can't find father with a shotgun.
Rather to anyone who wants to get their high school.
Well, they fixed the car up nice. Another Chattanooga Southern train running speedy freight to your knees. Uh-oh, accident with injuries. The rescue team will take him out to the hospital, put him in the ambulance, take him to the hospital where he does get very good care. You got the light going on top. We're going up to Bear Paw Falls now. There's some controversy as to why it's named that. Some people say they saw a bear paw going down the fall. It's obvious the man was naked. Oh, and here's a view of our airplane after we're down on the ground. This is looking over the northern part of the layout. Here's the end, the last place that anybody will ever let you down. A cemetery on the hill. Somebody paying their respect. Oh, we must have a newcomer. And this is the end of the tour of the layout. We hope you have enjoyed it.
Clock about 5 to Captain Nelson. of locomotives we got here today. Looks like a GP40. Where's the train headed? To Atlanta. Yep, my name is Mark McAllister. George Fletcher, and nice meeting you here today.
Thank you. Thank you.